Welcome to
my glass house. This is all about the Aspergers, a form of autism I live with every day. I used to be a very private person. Didn't want to go on Facebook. But what happened with the police and what keeps happening with the police is too much for me to handle. It's forced me to live in a house of glass so I can share everything that goes on with everybody else. I don't care anymore. I've been backed into a corner, and I'm going to tell you what happened to me. This police takedown of an unarmed autistic man at 2 a.m. at a truck stop parking lot. It was me! I was taken down. Deputy Ashton Thornberry of Mount Sterling, Kentucky, didn't know how to deal with disabilities. It was all about the gun that I didn't have. He wasn't qualified because he didn't have crisis intervention training. His sergeant said so. He told me that he was happy as long as he got that little card with the signature on it, and he'd go ahead and hire them. Asperger's apparently is a crime. Ashton had a right to expect that I was totally normal, and that I should not have been allowed to have a panic attack because of the autism. Do I have a right to have a disability accommodated by the police? Apparently no. Apparently, they have a right to expect me to be normal and treat me just like anybody else. But if that's the case, and I'm injured because I have a disability and I don't respond properly to him, I ought to have a cause of action. Do you think? I got an attorney opinion that says so. It says that the law says I should be accommodated for my disability. And even though Ashton has sovereign immunity against me and I can't sue them for practically anything, I still have a right to have my disability respected. My attorney, by the way, he wouldn't take the case unless I had a $7,500 retainer for investigation. That was all the money I had. He knew it. I ran out of money. He said he'd go ahead and file it if I got a job. But in October, near the end, with 8 weeks to go, he changed his mind. And then he said, well, I told you. He wrote me a letter. He explained it in the letter. I had 8 weeks. I contacted 71 offices. I had some very good responses. Even the Norris Law Firm would have liked to have taken the case if Kent would have just left me enough time. This autism, it's Asperger's. It's a developmental disability. I don't have a mental illness. Well, I didn't. I just don't want to be touched. It's extreme anxiety when I'm touched. When the police want to touch me, it's horrible anxiety. And I just seem odd to everybody, all the time. The same kind of thing happened to me the summer before at Fleet Farm in Appleton when I bought a sander, saw something that was lost, reported it to customer service, asked them to announce it. They gave me the eye roll. I got out, ready to leave. The police showed up. The Grand Chute Police Department handled it differently. They had CIT training. They just simply said, good evening, ran the license, left it in the parking lot where I asked them to lay it, and let me go on my way. I expect to be treated the same way here, but I wasn't. I was just doing my job. I was out of my job, out of Chicago, delivering cargo to a nearby warehouse. I was hungry. I went to the Shell Super Express truck stop, 100 Clarence Drive, Mount Sterling, Kentucky. I must have just seemed odd to this employee, Tessa Thornberry. She called 911 on me and lied about how long I'd been there. She said I was a suspicious person. But here in the police blotter, it says a male was acting suspicious. I had asked if I could fill a blue 1 gallon water container with water. I just didn't want her to touch it. Then I asked her to melt some cheese on the biscuit. That's all. I even apologized for maybe being a little odd. All I did was come in a second time to thank them. She said I was there 2 hours. But this shows that I was there only 47 minutes. Can't blame me for being hungry. So I asked if she'd mark wave the trees. I got the eye roll when she said no. I shut my mouth, went out and ate it, enjoyed it. I went back in to thank them because I got an eye roll and I thought maybe they'd think I was a little odd. Everybody does. I got autism. But when I got back in my van and started to leave, that man showed up. Yeah, he showed up and said, what are you doing here? He was angry. I explained to him about the autism. I told him about the Asperger's, that I might seem a little odd to him or do something he doesn't understand. I explained if he touched me, I'd have to change my clothes and wash. Could I just drop my clothes and let him see I didn't have a gun? But he grabbed at me. Then he said he's going to have to take me down, told me to turn around. He threw me on the ground. He kicked me in the back of my legs, my face slamming towards the ground. I had to turn my head to keep from breaking my nose. He had me handcuffed. I was frustrated. I had autism. I banged my head 3 times on the ground out of frustration. He threatened to tase me, so I stopped. That proves I was rational. He assaulted me. He frisked me. He locked me in his car. And then he went in my van. Nobody went in my van. Hey, I saw him in there. I knew I was going to have to wash every single thing in there. I saw him working my cat over with the leash. Then he went and got me and made me put my cat in his car. It messed me up. He had broken my cat's rear claw. They took me to the ER in St. Joseph's Hospital in an ambulance, bleeding in handcuffs, sitting in that room. The nurses didn't want to take pictures of me because they knew I wanted evidence. Mark Sparkman, he was a Master of Science degree psychologist. He decided that I caused my own injuries to myself. Somehow he didn't get the message. Ashton never told that Ashton did this to me, so he just figured I was a danger to myself. He wouldn't even acknowledge. Well, if you might have possibility, you might have Asperger's. He decided I was a danger to myself, and that in order to protect myself against myself, I nearly have 3 college degrees. I nearly have my nursing degree done. How can I be a danger to myself? I worked in a nursing home to help old people. How could I be a danger to myself? Possible autism. Possible? You don't take people off the street. Well, we just need to see if you got autism. We just need to get you the diagnosis, the help that you need. Well, I was doing fine before you came along, thank you. Impaired judgment. I would like to see what the public thinks about my judgment. But Mark didn't use critical thinking. He thought I did all my own injuries, but he didn't see all the injuries on my knees and my pants, my shoes and my wrists. You take one look at that. How can a person cause all that just by banging their head from 3 inches away? So he had me committed and put in a mental hospital. Guess what? I was diagnosed with Asperger's. OCD, I knew I had that. A 45% functioning? Well, after what just happened to me, I guess so. I was kept a whole week instead of 72 hours. It was the assault, the strip search, and the involuntary commitment that really messed me up at this place. I'm Carl. The psychiatric practitioner told me, of all the people she'd met, I had great coping skills. Further proof of my sanity. She told me on day 3, you don't belong here. It's interesting to note that me, with Asperger's, figured out how to cope with life, get my own job, survive out on my own, get out there, and be what the goal for everybody was for Asperger's, to be out on their own. But after what happened to me here, it pushed me back decades. Now I have a mental illness. I have PTSD. I've hurt my hand, bit my wrists. I've got damage on my arm now. My arm hurts, my hand hurts. And I gotta listen to the radio 24 hours a day. Because if my mind wanders, it'll remember this. The strip search. It was devastating. I cried 4 days straight because of the humiliation. Maybe a normal person wouldn't, but I'm not quite so normal. Read this. I had a personal secret. I avoided doctor's exams because of them. I didn't want anything in the medical records for decades. And this nurse was about to find out my secret. It was humiliating. Absolutely humiliating. My private secret was I was not all there. She threatened me that she'd bring the police in to remove my clothes. I felt like I was between a rock and a rock. Then there was the camera at the table. I asked her about it. She picked it up, didn't let me see it, looked at it, put it right back down. And then as she just stared at that area for the longest time, I was extremely uncomfortable. And when it was over, I wanted to know if she noticed. Maybe she'd think that I was just a little cold or something. I wanted to know if she'd write it in the records. But I know from my BSN training, you're not supposed to show any emotions or any recognition of anything that's out of the ordinary. I told her, I'm really messed up if you do this to me. I will have to fix this in my mind. I'll have to find a way to deal with this. She wanted to know what it was, but I wouldn't tell her. Her name is Karen Bauman. Why aren't there gender-appropriate nurses to do this to people? She should have determined from my statements that doing this to me would cause me permanent and severe harm. She's supposed to mitigate this kind of trauma, not perform procedures on people that might be permanently damaging to him. Nurses have that responsibility. I'm in recovery now. The day after I was let out, Jim, who I worked for, told me they didn't want someone who goes crazy working for them every time they're stopped by the police. I think he should read my attorney opinion. He gave me a lecture. 15 minutes he lectured me. And after a year, the lawsuit kept me going. For the first 5 months, I washed absolutely everything in my van. Absolutely everything. Then I contacted an attorney. I found this man in Lexington. He claims that the reason for the big delay was the 10 days I needed to look at the medical records to see if Karen Bauman wrote that one detail about my private parts in the medical records, because I didn't want anyone to see it. I wanted to know first. I applied for SSI. I figured, you know, the government agency said that if you don't have enough years, you can apply for SSI. So I did. And then they come right back and say, well, you don't have enough years. I felt like I was banging my head against a wall. I'm not going to get the disability to make up for what the police did to me, my job loss. But I am a praying man. I sent out 2 emails. Can you believe this? An email came back saying that they were willing to work with my older, well-taken care of Anne. But I'll be out there with the police again, and I have greatly reduced coping skills. I'm at a much greater risk for harm now. I'm going to make a poster. I'll explain about myself at each truck stop. I'll avoid the police like the plague because people don't seem to understand my odd behavior. You know, once police get involved, odd things happen. It's not just people of color. Mentally ill and developmentally disabled people have problems with the police too. I was working on a BSN at UWO. I'd entered with a 4.0 and I was written up and expelled. I didn't seem to get along with anybody. The students had complaints. I had problems with privacy. I didn't like my social security number and my titer results on the medical records. They got rid of me. I felt bad, but I had to prove to myself I was not the kind of person they said I was. The people there that made the complaints made fun of me. One of their boyfriends made fun of me. And my instructors would treat me differently than the other people in the clinical group. Even though I could have got what I wanted there, the medical record changed so that I could be happy with them, they were unwilling to do that for me. They explained one day in class that they had to take people that were a little odd, but then they would use the write-up program to get rid of them later. It would be the third write-up that would get rid of them. I remember a couple other middle-aged gentlemen explained this to me, and I thought, well, this is not going to happen to me. I'm a good guy. Well, it turned out that I spent a $21,000 student loan at a new college in a new nursing school to find out what a totally wonderful environment a nursing school really could be. I did great at AASU. I did pre-C-section catheterizations, Dabov tubes, blood draws, sim labs. The tests were harder, but I didn't have any write-ups. I had great relationships with everyone. It just goes to show what trouble just a few people can cause. But I couldn't afford to finish. And I had a problem with Pearson View and their biometric test-taking maniacal issues. I don't want to give fingerprints to take a nursing board. And the FBI fingerprinting was unbelievable. Well, because of all this, I don't think I'm up to nursing school anymore. I just want to be left alone. I just want to do my job. Please leave me alone. If you ask me again, I'm not getting out of the van. Just shoot me. I didn't mean that. I just want to be left alone. And I have a camera now. And I want to get back to where I was, eventually. So I'm happy in my home on the road. And I love God. He brought me through this whole thing. He gave me the ability to move on. In Jesus' name.